So I've already improved on my performance in my previous cube draft video, but let's see if we can take it all the way home here. Note that I saved the Verdant Catacombs because I have Lotus Cobra, Course of Gruffix, and Oracle of Moldiah. It's all fine reasons to wait. So I had been wondering what my opponent was going to be playing. I've already played against a white weenie deck and a blue control deck, and from the draft it didn't seem like there were many other green drafters, but a red deck does make sense. Well, my hand just turned awkward after that tree speaker died. I have to say this Genesis wave has not been good for me. I've usually not had trouble winning once I get to the 11 mana zone. All right, Grixis control. Probably, if my opponent taps out for something, I'm going to play Whisperwood Elemental. If not, I will play the Silverheart and, yeah, I'll Soul Bond. Mold Drifter. Okay, so cool. I get to play Whisperwood Elemental. That'll work out fine. Still not going to crack my fetch land. Oh, I can play Garrick too. Is that better? let me take a second to think about this. If I play Garrick, I get to plus, and then my opponent can probably have like a 3 damage burn spell or something like that. I think I want to actually just get some presence on the board with the Whisperwood Elemental. If I can play Garrick once my opponent's already on the back foot, that'll be really ideal. And I don't want a Genesis wave for less than 5. I've already drawn Garrick, but still, like, a lot of my powerful stuff costs exactly 5 mana. In a perfect world, I'd do it for X equals 8 and have the chance to hit the Craterhoof, but X equals 5, I'm going to say, is the bare minimum that I am willing to be casting that card for. After my opponent terminated the tree speaker, I've had a little bit of a slow start here, so he's almost in range of, Nicol Bolas and crazy stuff, Titans, stuff that's going to kill me pretty fast. But I have a stacked hand also, so I can trade Haymakers for a while. Soul Ring, yikes. Card's extremely good. Wow. You know what I hope my opponent is not playing is Splinter Twin combo deck, because that's hard to beat with mono green. Ouch. Well, nothing I can do about that, but that really sucks. I lose the last, some of the most powerful cards remaining in my deck. Against Rakdos's return, it's even more important to have a fast start, so that's going to affect my mulligan decisions, my sideboarding. Weird chump blocking? That's unexpected. That makes more sense to me. I meant to play Forest, but I clicked through. That's fine though. Not the best card to manifest. I wish it was the other one, the Thelenite Hermit. Well, sacrifice. Turn this face up. What? Why didn't it work for till end of turn, face up non-token creatures you control, gain. Oh, man. I did it in the wrong order. Wow, that really stinks. Really stinks. Yeah, that's going to be about it. My opponent's deck looks quite good. Like, any game that he draws the Soul Ring, is so much powerful stuff. Maybe this is going to be the time to bring in opposition. Keep him off these giant sorcery speed plays. Alright, well, not too many outs from this spot. Green Sun Zenith for... nothing. I concede. So, I could bring in the Opposition, I could bring in the Bloodbraid and the Xenagos. Maybe these guys could be good. Is there anything that I want to cut? I'm not super excited about Genesis Wave or Sylvan Caryatid, but if I bring in another color, I want to keep the Caryatid. Wall of Roots. And I could bring in the Xenagos and the Bloodbraid Elf. Or the Opposition. Let's give the Opposition a try. See how it goes. Oh, Winter Orb for sure I want. So I will then take out the Wall of Roots. Add a couple islands. And we'll see. Remember, I added two islands, but I actually had thought about my mana base a lot ahead of time. I have Misty Rainforest, Search for Tomorrow, Lotus Cobra, and Sylvan Caryatid as extra ways to produce blue mana. And Mox Sapphire. And this is just exactly the way I drew it up. So turn one, I want to play the Caryatid, I believe. No, not the Sol Ring. Well, I have my best draw. He has his best draw. It seems only fair, I guess. Gonna play the Oracle first. I can't use the opposition right away, obviously, but I do get to either play a land off the top or play that treetop village. Whoa. Yeah, I'm gonna wait on the search for tomorrow. I can use it sort of to like scry with the Oracle. Rakdos's return coming. Wow, big turn for my opponent. So I can either play the Silverheart. Yeah, I mean that's pretty much all I can do is play the Silverheart. I will soul bond and just hope that an 8/8 gets there. How is it that I played turn two Oracle of Moldiah on the play and my opponent's turn two was even better? Clone the Oracle, play an extra land, terminate your Oracle. Brutal. The Sol Ring is just brutal. It's the best card in the cube. Olivia Voldaren is not going to be easy for this deck to beat either. This is like the nightmare matchup. If I make it to game three, I'll have to bring in Beast Within, I guess, just to kill Olivia. Well, shuffling away the Olivias, good news. Imperial Recruiter for what? Moldrifter? Well, I get to come in for a big attack here. It's a shame that the Imperial Recruiter is so good at chump blocking the 8/8 Silverheart. Just need a great top deck here, like a Garrick or something. Can even cast Craterhoof Behemoth if I draw it. My opponent does seem to be a little stalled on lands despite having the Oracle. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if he had Demonic Tutor for Underground Sea last turn. Now, Imperial Recruiter, probably for Moldrifter, would make sense. I hope he doesn't get any free lands off the top. Ophiomancer. Death Touch Snakes. Well, that's bad for me. Craterhoof. That's good for me. This card is excellent. Question is, should I destroy Sol Ring or start making dudes? think I want to just start making dudes. There's just no guarantees that I'm going to be able to keep my opponent off of mana when he has the Oracle. Oh, I can destroy the Oracle also. Maybe that's the best move. But then I would lose Frailes. I'll wait. I'll make a guy first and then reevaluate next turn. Problem is, I'm just losing, like, on the board, so I can't really make conservative plays right now. Okay, well, now maybe I'll destroy the Sol Ring. Still, my opponent only has access to 7 mana. Ultimate price in hand, some other non-land cards. Yeah, that's fine. Just gonna let that through. Means I actually get to attack back with the Silver Heart, although I guess clearly my opponent's drawn the ultimate price, so. Char, sure. Ooh. Painful. All right, come on, top deck. I don't have 8 mana anymore, so the Crater Hoof doesn't do it. Elvish Mystic's not going to do it either. Is it worth trading the treetop for the skin render? Doesn't seem like it. But I do get a clean attack with the Silver Heart. I just have to hope my opponent doesn't have a land on top. My opponent's hand is ultimate price and some non-land card, and Nicol Bolas comes into play, and Damnation on top. So, looks like this is we're nearing the end, ladies and gentlemen. Yep, that's fine. I don't have any blue spells left in my deck anyway. Top deck? Ooh, not quite. Yeah, I guess it's time to concede. My opponent just needs to Damnation and destroy one of my lands, and then there's no way I can possibly come back. Even without the Olivia on top, there's no way I could possibly come back. This is a good play by my opponent, making me activate the treetop before Damnation. Maybe I can incentivize him to not damnation by losing a bunch of my creatures. Nope, he's not going to fall for that. All right, good game. I tried my hardest, but this was a tough matchup and the games didn't go the way I needed them to go. But I hope you had fun watching. I definitely had fun drafting, and tune in next time.